First, I would like to talk about this art gallery. I can see so much good energy around. There's so much creativity, and most importantly, all your support to make this art show, this charity, successful. And I think we all are very much in gratitude for that. And this is how gratitude starts. And when I look at gratitude, we want to see all the good things in life, but that also puts attention to the duality of the other things, which is the setbacks that we face in life or our challenges. And how do we cope with that is basically when we have an attitude of gratitude and we just start taking a look at what is it that we can derive from the situation and look at our life very holistically and see the goodness where it exists and lead our life with more compassion. I'd just like to tell you a very short story, if stories resonate with you. There is a young man, he's roaming in a desert and he sees a spring of crystal clear water, and he wants to carry it for his master. So he has a leather container and he just carries it and travels 4 days to his master's village and presents the water to him. The master is very happy. He takes a sip and says, "This is the elixir of life." And the student is very happy. He goes back to his village with warmth in his heart. There's another student sitting. He asks his master, "I would also like to take a sip." But when he takes the sip, he throws the water out and says, "This is really foul. And why did you pretend to like it, master? It's really bad." And the master said that, "For me, the water was a container of an act of kindness and love. And what can be more sweeter than that?" And that is what gratitude is all about. Well, gratitude is very, very good for our mental health, our physical health, because we can really just be in sync with our positive emotions. And when we look at life with an attitude of gratitude, a lot of things start happening for us. We attract the right things in our lives. And I also want to tell you about what science says about it. Science says that there is a very strong connection between creativity and gratitude. So when we I'm sure artists will agree to it, that they can go in this flow state when they are very into their painting and something beautiful comes out. Because at that moment, when you are in the attitude of gratitude for that present moment, I think it gets beyond the product, but more for that experience of the process, that you get that creative flow and a beautiful output comes. I'm sure both of you will agree to this, that when you're in your flow, what wonderful things come out. And I think every human being is creative, and every human being has this wonderful creativity inside that's bursting. So please look into yourself and see where you can be most creative and you can really change lives, and first and foremost change your own life by being more productive, because I think we are all capable, wholesome inside. We just need that light to shine on us and we'll be very bright. And I'll just end this talk with one poem that I have on artist. It's called The Artist's Poem, which is written by some person called Alexander. I just found it on the net and I found it was very meaningful for the art gallery today. So it says, "Give me the eyes to see, the ears to hear, the heart to feel, the creativity within me and without. In every bit of nature, every speck of air, every part of humanity, and all this vast universe, I'm content to be a creative force and a source within and without. Let the energy flow from me and to me." And this is the artist's poem. And I would say that gratitude is a magnet for miracles. There's a quote that I remember. And I'll end with Rumi's words. And he says that gratitude is the wine for the soul. So go on, get drunk.
I would just want to thank Leela ma'am for all the... would have never happened.